final-year PhD student in the NACB, and today I'm going to be talking about resistance mechanisms in breast cancer. So breast cancer is the second most common cancer in women in Ireland. A woman has a 1 in 10 chance of developing breast cancer before her 75th birthday. And this is reflected in the global incidences of breast cancer as well, which are currently increasing. However, it's not all bad news. The 5-year survival of breast cancer patients has dramatically improved over the past 10 to 15 years. And the main challenge now is to optimize the treatment that patients are getting and preventing resistance to these treatments from developing. So what is breast cancer? Breast cancer is more than one disease, as Dennis has spoken about already. There's the hormone receptor positive that relies on estrogen, the HER2 positive, and then the triple negative that lacks either hormone receptor or HER2. And the focus of my research has been on HER2 positive breast cancer. So as Dennis has said, that these cancer cells rely on HER2 to stimulate the cell growth and survival signals. However, about 15 years ago, HER2 targeted therapies were introduced. These can either bind to HER2 on the outside of the cell or on the inside of the cell. Herceptin would bind to the outside, and then small molecules like lapatinib and neratinib would bind to the inside. And these stop the cell growth signals and cause cell death. However, cancer cells can find alternative methods of increasing the growth signals. And then the cancer cell displays resistance to the HER2 targeted therapies, so they need to be treated with some other type of drug. So our research in the NICB has focused on growing HER2 positive breast cancer cells in the lab, treating them with HER2 targeted therapies, now waiting for resistant cells to emerge. This can be a quick process, or it can take 6 to 12 months. We then analyze these cells, looking at protein levels, genetic changes, trying to find different druggable weaknesses. So these would be particular targets in the cancer cell that can be targeted with drugs that either are currently approved for other cancers or are in clinical development. So what we then do is treat the resistant cells with these drugs, and the best candidate drugs can then progress to a clinical trial. So an example of this, these are HER2-positive breast cancer cells. They were treated for 6 months with a HER2-targeted therapy agent. They're then examined by different protein experiments to find what changes occurred in the cells, and they've showed an increased sensitivity to an already approved anti-cancer drug called dasatinib. So you can see here that the cells, when they're treated with the HER2 targeted therapy, doesn't respond at all. It's still growing and still healthy. When you treat with the dasatinib, the cells are starting to die, and then when you combine the two, you see cell death. So this is occurring in drug-resistant cells. But we also want to see, can we prevent the resistance from developing in the first place? So if we take cells that are sensitive to HER2-targeted therapy and treat them with both HER2-targeted therapy and other drugs, what will happen? So the darker the blue, the more cells. So you can see cells that don't get any treatment continue to grow. There's about a 50% growth decrease when you treat with the HER2 targeted therapy and the dasatinib alone. We see a massive effect when you combine the two. But importantly, resistance does emerge with both of these agents, but it doesn't when you combine the two together. So this would be a candidate combination that could be used in the clinic. So we've found in center that HER2-targeted therapy resistance can be modeled in the lab, but it can be overcome. So there are different therapeutic regimens